I feel like I am in for a treat today because you guys have left many comments that the next Morissette song I need to listen to is Against All Odds. It's Tommy Mars. I'm back here with another Maury video. Here's the thing. Phil Collins is one of my favorite faves, okay? I listen to his music constantly. One of my fave Phil Collins songs is Against All Odds. It's from a movie that is not one of my favorites. I've seen it. It's okay. It's an 80s movie. It's not bad. But his song, Against All Odds, growing up, was actually one of my favorite songs by him. A lot of it is because of the emotion that he shows at the end. So when I saw this in the comments, I was like, no way. Because I always felt like, and I love his version. Clearly, I love his version. And I always wished that one of my favorite singers would come along and kind of cover that song. So I know, I'm aware there's a Mariah Carey version out there. I think she's, I mean, top notch, one of the great voices and stuff. And I love Mariah's very first record. That's actually my favorite one by her. And then, All I Want for Christmas. That's almost like Christmas right there. That's a standard Christmas song by Mariah Carey. But for me, I was waiting till I heard that voice to come along that I love the tone of. I love that the way she sings it. I like the runs that she does, all these things. And Maury is that person for me. Everything that she does vocally, I just like. I haven't heard her make a move yet that I was like, I don't know about that. I haven't heard that yet. For me, this is almost like a dream to have what I call one of my favorite female vocalists of all time in Morissette cover a song that is one of my favorite songs. So it just almost doesn't get better than this. I've been thinking about this song and how her voice might sound on it. And I'm so intrigued at the possibilities. So let's get into it. Oh, live players in the studio. Great.
How can I just let you walk away? Just let you leave with that dress. When I stand here taking every breath with you. You're the only one who really knew me at all.
Wish 107.5.
How can you just walk away from me? When all I can do is watch you leave.
That look on her face, it just... Oh, Maury. Just so easy, the stuff she does. She just makes it look so simple. And that was awesome. She almost... myself breathing with her. The little smiles at the end, it is like the, if you look up the word, go, you can pause me, go to Google and look up the word adorable. There will be a picture of Maury's face. All right. So the part I mentioned, right, when I like before I felt like I was kind of like losing it was I felt like she like waved to somebody or did something there, but it was that little run that she did right there. And it almost was like, it was just second nature. I'm just going to pop in this huge, awesome, expansive run that nobody else can do. And she's just like, hey, how you doing? Watch this. Boom. She is something else. She is something else. I know I said this before. I'm feeling so grateful that I'm on this path. I'm on this journey of finding Maury's music. To hear her voice, it's just, the tone of it is just something so special. If you watch any of my stuff on here, there's a couple things you'll always hear me talk about. I'll talk about production. I'll talk about the spectrum, where things sit on the spectrum when you go into the mix. The other thing I always talk about is tone. You can't teach tone. You're born with a certain tone. It's almost like the way your fingers sound on a guitar. Your fingers sound the way they sound. It's the shape, it's the roughness, all that stuff about your fingers. It's the same thing with vocals. The tone that she has that comes out of her body is, it's so superior to almost anything I've ever heard, just tonally wise. And there's been singers where I love their tone and they weren't that great, like mechanically. They weren't the best singers in the world, but the tone I just really loved. And then there'll be some singers that are like, we'll call it like hitting runs and doing those things. They're amazing. Their tone is just not my thing. It's not my favorite thing I've ever heard. With Morissette, it's one of those things where I love both of them. I love them both. It's like right now I'm on that Dimash series right now. I'm on my second Dimash song. It's the same thing with him. He has all of the technique in the world, but he also has this tone that when he does this breathy tone, it's amazing. It makes me want, I feel like I can move mountains. And that's what I feel just now when I watch Maury get up there, sing Against All Odds, one of my favorite songs, and she gets into that part I talked about at the beginning of the video. And I'm sorry if I'm talking fast because I'm excited here. I am so excited because at the beginning of the video, I was talking about how Phil Collins really goes for it at the end. There's just an empty space. You know, he just goes for it. He just did something there. I feel like it's forever going to stick in my head. I've been hearing her voice in my sleep, and that's the way it is with a couple artists. I dream them. I dream about their voice, and it's not even really looking at them. It's just I hear them in my sleep. She is one of those, so that's kind of how I felt coming into this, was like, I can't wait to hear this version because, like I said, I'm a fan of the original, and now I'm a fan of hers. I got to rip this version onto an MP3 from my SD card in my car because I have to listen to this thing in the car. I feel like a lot of my world, my music world, has been turned completely upside down. I feel like it's changed a lot. Well, it has changed in the last 6 months. My listening habits have changed a ton. Because if you know anything about me, I'm rock music. That's my background. That's how I've toured my band. That's how I've charted records. All that stuff is from rock music. But I've always had this pop sensibility. I've always loved Michael Jackson. I love Justin Timberlake. I'm a huge Harry Styles fan. I'm into BTS. You know, all these things. But 6 months ago, I didn't hear anything of Harry or BTS, or now Morissette, Dimash, Marcelita. I didn't hear any of it. And here I am right at the end of 2020 with all of you listening to these songs. It's amazing, man. What a crazy year. And it's been crazy and it's been bad in a lot of ways, but I'm going to be honest with you. It's been great for me personally, music wise. This has been something else. And now I feel so fortunate that I found Maury, that this journey that we're on right now together, you and I, this one's going a long time. All right, if you want to get at me socially, TOMMYMARZBAND, Tommy Mars Band, Twitter, Instagram, come hit me up. And you know what? Here's the question of the video. Okay, you ready? For me, I celebrate Christmas. So if anybody knows of any Christmas song or holiday songs that Maury have sang and they have a good link, I need you to either drop that below in the comments of this video, or I need you to tweet at me. I just gave you my handle. Tweet at me or send me a DM on Instagram. I need some good links to some really good holiday music that Morissette has sang because I want to do a video this week. I know this is Monday for me, but Christmas is on Friday. I'm going to put out another Maury video this week if you guys give me a good link to something Christmas, holiday, something that she's done, okay? So that's it. If you guys give me a good one, I'll have it out before Christmas Day. All right, I'm going to get out of here. I am going to watch that one again. I'm going to watch it again. Sick, man. It's so good. So good. It's Tommy Mars. I will see you in the next video. I think I'm going to see you guys in a couple days because I know you're going to give me the link to the best holiday song that Maury has done. All right, you guys take care. I'll see you soon. You're the only one who really knew me at all.